Hello everybody and welcome. Today we're going to be looking at the drilling in Sniper Elite, which is a double-barreled side-by-side shotgun with a rather interesting feature. The drilling has a third barrel underneath the two standard barrels that takes a rifle round. So it's effectively a rifle crossed with a shotgun. I mean, talk about overpowered, like two really great things in one holy blessed package. So without further ado, we're gonna hop right into this. So, the drilling, how does it compare to the trench broom and the rifles in the game? Well, if I was out for just a shotgun, I'd rather use the trench gun. It's got a better fire rate, a higher magazine capacity. I know the damage and the range are slightly worse, but it's still a very, very good weapon. And if I was out for a rifle, I'd use the Kirkano. Well, that's not true, I'd use the DeLisle. But if I was out for a proper rifle and not some silenced pea shooter, I would use the Kirkano. So why is the drilling really good? Well, basically put, it's because of its versatility. Basically every secondary weapon in the game is some short range spray and pay submachine gun, or failing that, it's a trench broom, and that's short range as well. So having the drilling, which can actually hold its own up to like medium range, I'm talking DeLisle range, so it's pretty good. It's impressive, and it even works at close range. A rifle shot followed up by a shotgun blast can be very, very effective, even at like above SMG ranges, and that's a very powerful tool. So, I think the best place and the best way to use the drilling is either for a vehicle removal role. It works well at like destroying trucks and stuff in the earlier levels. It's very good at that. Or as like a sort of long range SMG. As in, you hit them with the rifle shot, and you don't have to like reload when you're switching to the shotgun shells because they're all contained at once. Unlike rifle ammo, where you've got to reload to switch between normal ammo and silenced ammo. But you hit them with a rifle shot. If you're lucky, that'll kill them, but most of the time it won't. It'll only like half kill them. And then you follow up with a shotgun blast, and that's enough to take out basically anyone. So that's a very good way of doing it. I also really like, as I say, that you don't have to reload switching ammo. I don't know what sort of ungodly combination of triggers that has to entail, considering that a regular side-by-side shotgun, especially one of that age, will have two triggers anyway, one for each barrel. I don't know what happens when you put in a third barrel, but, you know, it's interesting, isn't it? Now, the way I'd say to run a drilling is with a Kirkano as your main weapon. The Kirkano is the, like, rangiest of all the sniper rifles, and it's good for medium to long range. I'll be putting up a fancy graphic to show this. And the drilling is very good at short to medium range, and then if you back that up with a strong pistol like the Webley or the M1911, you'll be basically unstoppable. You'll have all bases covered. It's not a very stealthy loadout. I don't think the drilling is best suited for stealth, but it's a very, very good loadout nonetheless. I'd suggest taking some silenced rifle ammo or silenced pistol ammo with you if you needed to do stealth, but I think generally this is going to be killing as many people as quickly as possible unlike a class with like a DeLisle and a well rod, where it's about how you kill them and how you aren't noticed when you're doing that. So it's a very good class and I'd recommend taking it. So that's gonna do it for today. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like. Don't worry, I'm not gonna pressure you into doing it. I hate it when you get the YouTubers and every 5 seconds are either telling you to leave a like or putting up a really annoying graphic saying leave a like, because it winds me up no end. So yeah, have a nice day and goodbye.